goddamn idiot. I love you. Fucking hang on! Hang on! Hold the fucking phone, everybody! Just wait!
A lot going on in here.
Jesus! You're sleeping! The fuck!
Hey, bro, what up?
Imminent death? No?
What's on your mind? No, don't tell me. Those monsters making life difficult for you? You need not be ashamed. We're all in the same boat, you know. I really have run up quite a debt to you.
Yeah, a little bit.
The time has come.
Now, the last time someone said, "Are these monsters making life difficult?" he did something cool.
Mm-hmm.
Fred, I have an idea. A good one, really. I will rush those dire fiends, and you can slip away in the confusion.
I don't know.
Please, Fred. I owe you much more than this. By the honor of the Knights of Katarina,
I don't know.
Allow me to assist you. And now, I go.
Well, he's gonna do it.
Oh, fuck.
Help him. Help him as fast as you possibly can.
Shit! 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 Okay. 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 I didn't want to kill him. I'm really strong.
You did it.
Christ almighty. Fucking Sieg.
It's like he you talk to him and he just fucking goes.
Leroy fucking Jenkins in the flesh, huh? Man. At least I got chicken.
Well, I'm certainly not backing down. By the honor of my knighthood.
Okay. You done for now? No, maybe not. Fuck you.
You having fun with this concept?
Not a ton of it. What? I aggroed him?
Too bad. That sucks.
I aggroed him?
Yep.
Why? Because I hit him.
Yep, you hit him too many times.
Ah! Damn it, I didn't think he was going to come up behind me.
Well, this is an interesting turn of events.
If I don't kill him,
I
can get pardoned.
That's true. That is true. Time to bone-itis out.
Shit.
So I'll be honest, Walls. I don't know what the fuck the state of the quest is right now.
Okay,
hold on. I don't know what sequence of events you just caused to happen.
Okay, hold on.
So you're gonna want- what you're gonna wanna do is you're gonna repair your shit,
yeah.
And we're gonna go pardon that shit,
yeah, yeah.
And then we're gonna come back and see what the fuck happened.
Ah! My swing is too broad for that zone! Damn it! And he had a threshold. I know I hit him.
Yeah, you absolutely hit him.
I know I did, but... really didn't mean to. I gotta switch to Uchi next time. Repair. Okay. So I don't know what to make of this.
Yeah, it's a little weird.
I absolved my sins.
We did absolve your sins.
But I left him in the muck.
Yep.
So that might be... no good.
Who the fuck knows?
He's not gonna hate me anymore.
You
yes!
Should. Hey!
Okay. Alright. Good.
Just talk to him.
Just talk to him, yeah.
Yeah, let's just talk to him.
Okay. I can't lock onto him, so.
So that's good.
Part two is still here. I'm fucking Uchiing from here.
Hey, what up?
Why? You! Didn't you get away? Well, you saved me once again. Dear me, what can I say? I have failed you. My dear little...
Oh.
So you want to hear the fun-ass conditions required to continue this storyline?
What?
Oh, So, also,
did
if you
just stand in poison and die?
So, also, if you complete the storyline properly, you can't get the speckled ring. Ever. So check that speckled ring, would you?
God damn it. Siege. You idiot. You're fucking...
There it is. It's a slight boost for magic, fire, and lightning. The precious stone plate is the symbol of a true knight. Grant the strength to face various hardships. The precious rare speckled stone plate grants a small boost to defense against magic, flame, and lightning. So here's the deal. The only way to actually do this quest properly and do it, like, on point is to do this, talk to Sieglin and say you've seen him. She'll disappear. Right? Save him from Blighttown. Say you've seen him and she'll disappear. Come down here. He then has to finish this encounter with more than 50% of his health.
More than 50% of his health.
Despite the poison and the fact that he jumps in. So, the only way to do it that I've ever found is you have to take a bow and arrow and hit,
kill them.
And no, because if you kill all of them, he's disappointed that he can't help you, and the quest ends.
Christ.
You have to bring them down to about one hit from death.
And let him do it.
And then jump in and kill them as fast as you possibly fucking can.
Just baby him and swaddle him, and then clean up the little burp under his chin.
At that point, you talk to Sieglind again, and she says that her dad's gone for one last adventure, and you find her crying at his grave in Ashley. And she will give you a slap.
You fucking... Ugh. Your descendant was so much smarter than you. Siegmeyer, like... Or Siegward?
Whatever your fucking name is.
Dark Souls 3 Sieg, like, he kinda got it. Like, you were pointing out the fact that he tells you, you jump too far! Too fast!
Why'd you do that?
He slows you down, huh? Ah, you dummy! You and fucking Solaire! You children!
Not just them. Logan does the same thing.
I got a bone out, huh?
I don't know. Maybe there's a way out.
There's two pits.
Well, what about that on your right that has the fucking thing on it?
Yeah, but you can't run up that.
Light. Oh. Maybe? Oh. Sunlight magnet? Maybe the light will just help you see better. Because it looks like you can just go past it on the left. But maybe I'm crazy.
I don't think so.
Nah? Alright, it does look like you're gonna have to bone out.
Da-da-da-da. Man. You dummies. You children.
Remember, Laurentius, if you tell him where you got the pyromancy, he also kills
himself. Does the same thing. They're all like that. Everybody's trying to do it, but no one's really good enough.
The crestfallen warrior, upon seeing that the task is completable, follows out.
No.
They all do it.
Once you get stronger than them, you have to then watch out for them.
And make them fail on purpose.
But feel like they're still on their quest.
Damn it. The worst thing you can do in Dark Souls 1
is help them. That's fucked up.
So if you complete all of their quests perfectly and do everything you can for them,
fucked up.
It's the worst thing that ever happened to them was meeting you.
And you told me this when we played DS2.
And DS3. And you're like, you didn't actually understand what that meant, because of course not. Why? That makes no fucking sense. It's like, no. The helping them is worse for them than had they never met you at all.
Man.
That's how shit Lordran is. It sucks here.
Mental fragility is a serious issue.
And that's one of my favorite... That is my favorite concept of the Soul series. Is that success sows the seeds of your failure. In DS2, my favorite character that does this is the shopkeeper, who starts to lose his mind as he makes more money.
Yeah. But like, it's such a weird thing where it's like, you're like, the going hollow and being undead and all these little concepts that are introduced are all things that you're semi-familiar with in, like, terms of zombies and you know, like, fiction.
But it's tied to your mental state.
Yeah, but the idea of being, like, satisfied is also bad? What? You're not even allowed to be happy?
So, like, the thing is, right, it's
dude, come on, tell me that doesn't look like a monster waiting up top of this.
Oh, it super does. So, the undead curse... Like, here's the thing. The undead curse is only a problem for people who lack the will. Right? Mm. The character that you play as in all three games is invincible because they're the player. And the player is going to beat the game.
Yeah. Yeah.
Right?
No matter what.
But
damn it, he doesn't stay dead.
Everybody else in society doesn't necessarily have that level of gumption. So it's not dying a million times makes you hollow, right? It emaciates your body and fucks you up. It's the fact that the pointlessness of dying over and over and over is what gets you, right? Mm-hmm. And unless you have a strong goal to work towards, dying over and over, which sucks, yeah, it's gonna make you lose your will to live, right? But then if you push past that with a core thing of like, well, I can deal with this as long as I can have my quest, or I can go on adventures, or I can be an honorable man, or I can learn everything, right? Well, if that's what you use to push through that existentialist crisis, fine. But then all of a sudden, that crutch is gone.
Yep.
You learned everything there is to learn.
There's nothing.
There's no more adventures to be had.
And the fucked up thing is that we all sit here going through our nihilist, like, you know, jargon constantly because there really is no meaning.
I love it. The entropy of the universe is infinite.
But the fact that, like, we have no meaning to our day-to-day
doesn't turn us into zombies.
No! You know what I mean? You manage to just, you go, well, I guess there's nothing.
I'll fall in that pit again.
No, there's nothing else.
There's nothing over there either.
Yeah. You just
want to crawl back up and follow the main path now.
You kind of just fucking realize it, and then you go, all right, well, yeah. We just continue on then. I'll eat food, and I'll
maybe I'll be bummed out sometimes and have a sense of ennui.
And eventually I might feel like procreating, and that'll be the end of my existence. And that'll be that.
Well, you don't turn into an active threat to everyone around you and represent the downfall of all of society.
You know, motivation is a nice...
I can't believe you didn't fall off that. That's crazy.
Spice. But it's not the lifeblood that keeps you going.
Yeah, it is.
Oh, who are you?
Why would you let them cast?
Okay. You got me.
She.
I don't know. She.
Another one of the actively alive sisters.
I wanted to see what she would do. But you're right. I should have just stepped.
And we'll be back in a second, though.
I should have just stepped. So I just want to reiterate that the last thing I thought would happen was that she'd actually cast a spell that would kill me.
Yeah.
But, you know. Here we are.
Unfortunately, the witches are... Well, this one isn't on point. Hey, you got a her catalyst.
Yeah, I you know what I mean? Like, I'm like, okay, cutie, what do you got?
Yeah.
And then it's like, oh, power geisa.
Yeah.
There's more zone here.
There's a little bit more zone.
Don't break my weapons, man. Just stop.
Just chill. What's the thing say? Flyer ahead.
People use that term
constantly,
rather frivolously.
Hey! Those things are called Chaos Eaters. I was just looking up their wiki, in which if you fucking do a plunge attack on them, it fucks up and they eat you.
Of course! I could tell from the way that, like, that has to be for a reason. Ooh, Chaos Fire Whip!
An even better form of the
That whip. Sounds like fun.
What's the deal? Art of the Flame of Chaos, which engulfed the Witch of Isles and her daughters, sweeps foes with the Chaos Fire Whip. The Fire Whip was wielded by the eldest of the Daughters of Chaos.
Hmm.
Probably. Do me a favor and stab that wall over there.
Yeah.
Because if there's a bonfire in there, I'm gonna shit my ass.
Not here, please.
Okay.
Okay. The Chaos Whip, I wish it lasted a little longer.
But yeah, we always wish it does. But, hey, what's the ceiling look like in this place?
People are not kidding about it being a cool spell. Yeah, man. This is just, you're underneath the big tree thing still.
Okay, yeah. So this is the weird dome shit that's visible from the bonfire next to the Daughters of Chaos.
Like, so we're under an arch tree.
Yeah.
But at the same time, like, in the Ash Lake, we see tons of
ash trees.
So it's, I don't know.
Levels? You ready?
Are you ready? So here's the honest attempt?
Yep, here's the honest attempt before the cheating occurs.
Well, alright, let's see how bullshit can get.
Praise that sun.
Oh yeah, let's go! SSX tricky! It's tricky! What? It's tricky! Alright.
So that's where all the roots came from.
Okay.
That's the bed of chaos.
You're alive. Glowing orbs. You have my attention. Let's go there. That's the first thing. You gonna try to stop me?
They are. So you can see hitting the bed actually does nothing.
Okay.
But hitting the bullshit.
Okay. I saw another one on the other side.
You sure did.
Oh, you're like a tree Cthulhu.
Yeah.
I like that. Is that helping or? I don't know what this. Okay, well. Nope. That didn't help.
So the deal with the Bed of Chaos is that the Witch of Izalith. Enjoy your fight, by the way. The Witch of Izalith is the Chaos Flame.
Oh.
Like, that's the deal.
Oh. She became it?
Yeah.
Ooh.
And that's where all demons come from.
Oh.
So when she pulled that shit off, not only did it didn't work and turn her into a freakazoid, but it caused the birth of demons.
That's the closest thing to becoming a god that I can think of.
In so far, anyway. Well, here's gonna be a lot of cuts. See you, folks.
All right.
Round two.
God damn it, Shogi Meguro. Why are you so good?
We're talking about that Personas music. Guess what? It's dope.
Now, I managed to avoid that on the way in. Could it be that...
Every time you smack one of those, more of the four will fall apart.
Okay.
Oh, by the way.
That doesn't change.
Oh, I forgot. The boss has maintained its damage.
Oh, that's a huge difference. That's massive.
It's been a long time since I've done this.
And he slides you into the bullshit. Okay.
Like, just literally pushes you into pits.
Yeah.
Just little nudges. Like
oh,
that.
Oh, yeah. It's not about the attacks.
Hell no, it's not.
But the damage the fact that it stays, though, at least it stays.
Jesus. All caps montage. I have all caps montage written, and underneath it goes life will change instrumental. With the fucking ice music over this.
Why the big slide? You think
it's supposed to? Because you're going into the absolute heart of the city, like the literal centermost point.
But maybe it's to give you a little bit of fun.
Yeah.
Before you have
also remember, you're heading left. So
anti-fun, yeah.
Hit that left.
Yep. And the hole stays.
Yeah.
Good.
So basically, you're gonna learn where there's holes, and you're gonna just start to sprint and sprint and sprint.
Yep.
What a stupid fucking boss. Ugh.
That's a stab, that's a push. Okay.
You gotta get around that.
Oh boy.
Hey, look at that! Look at that! Look at that! Look at that! Hey! Two-thirds done. Two-thirds done. Maybe no need for the giant montage note that I have.
Now, the fact that they let it stay damaged between deaths tells me that that was their playtesting.
Yeah, they were like, okay, well, this is impossible.
If you get it once, you get it good.
Now figure out how to kill the boss. I'll give you a hint, you have to be in front of it.
Of course. He can kill me.
So the interesting thing about the Bed of Chaos is, like, it's one of the ones that, like, it's clearly no one ever got here before you. Right?
Those hurt. Oh! Those hurt.
They do hurt.
Shit.
Anytime you want some hints, I'll gladly give you one.
Hold on, I think I have something. Nope, that's not
it. Oh, look, pyromancy. Dude, it's the worst! It's the fucking worst!
Oh, man, okay. Out of this zone. Lock this. And then the slam comes down.
Alright.
I see it. I just couldn't get to it.
So here's a boss fight. You have to make a big jump to beat.
Yeah, I see it.
And you want to hear the fun part? It can knock you out of the air at random.
That's awesome. That sounds super cool.
Praise that sun.
No.
Alright, Wolves. Are you going to make that big-ass, cool-ass jump?
There's only one way to
go. You make that jump. Yo, Woolington, hit that ramp.
Aw, Fitty.
I think it's a straight fucking jump.
It's a straight jump. Depends on how fast I can run.
Depends how fast you can fucking run. And do you get the jump? Oh! No, you're good. Oh, no, you're not. Oh, shit. Try and get that jump. Oh, no. This boss fight sucks.
This is fucking...
Hey, we're back with the new and improved Woolington.
This is clown.
Hey, you want to see something funny?
This is clown shit.
No, back up. Okay.
What?
So, from that staircase, if you look over the edge, you can see into the void where they didn't finish building the level.
Awesome. This is clown shoes and kazoo music. And I'm like...
You're giggling now.
I'm laughing as much as I'm, like, crying in that sense, because I can't even fully hate it because of how... What?
Shut up, asshole.
When? Why?
Run! You idiot! Just keep doing it! Go!
We're going.
Heal up! Heal more! Congrats, you beat the Bed of Chaos. No, ignore it. Now it's a speed run.
Demon Souls? This reminds me of Demon Souls right here.
You want to hand it?
Yeah, maybe.
That's the Witch of Iceland. Turn. She's a giant version of the bug.
Clown shoes.
She's a tiny little bug.
And kazoo music. Okay?
Like, you didn't even get a good look at her because you killed her so fast. It was like, she looks like a big bug.
So is there an attack that comes out of that thing?
Eventually she'll do like a supernova. If you just stare at her for a while. It's terrible.
It's
terrible.
It is, and with that.
Hey! Look at that. Look at that shit.
It is funnier than it is stupid.
Would you agree that's like the worst? The, like, hands down.
It's the dumbest.
Yeah.
The worst, I'm still gonna give to Pinwheel. Because it's not a boss fight.
Pinwheel's fun.
It's not a boss fight.
Come on.
But you see, that demeanor is what I have with this.
Yeah.
I have, well, like, look at this stupid shit.
I'll tell you what. If you would see, Pinwheel will stop no one in their tracks, right? Beta Chaos, given a bad day, absolutely can.
This is so,
right?
This is fucking ridiculous.
I spent a whole Sunday on Beta Chaos because I just didn't get that. You got pretty lucky. You did it in four, right?
Yeah, and I understood. I think I understood it.
But it's the point. It's a moment that didn't happen to you. It almost did just now, but it didn't.
Where you're
midair and the boss just swats you into the pit.
You
get dunked.
Yeah, man.
That's the moment that just ingrains it in your heart. Just, you bitch.
Like, you're Steph Curry. You're the ball going up into the air, and LeBron is just like, get the fuck out of my house.
Gumby's you,
looking back at you like, who the fuck you think this is?
Well, you finished off every side quest.
I mean, look,
except for the ones that you can't because they're in the tomb, which would be haircut.
No,
haircut side quest is the only one yet to do.
Oh boy, oh joy, everybody. someone on the dev team just thought they were gonna have a nice little different creative idea.
It's an event boss.
Yeah.
And there are other event bosses, like the chariot in DS2 is I actually really like.
I like the chariot a lot. It's dramatic. And I felt really good when I rolled through the wheel.
And when you pull the lever up and the chariot eats hard shit.
Yeah, man, that's fine. Then you gotta fight the horse.
DS3.
I expected a fight after that.
DS3 has the goddamn dragon that you fucking drop on.
Mm-hmm. Like I talked about it earlier, I was like, I had expectations for what this was gonna be, and I thought it was gonna be. Do I have enough? No, I don't. It's 15.
No, not even.
I thought this was going to be a lava bed that just spews bullshit at me, and then there would be points or crystals or something to go
stab. So you were right about the crystals.
You know?
But instead of lava, it was instant death pits.
I never would have called that shit.
And the boss doesn't so much fight you as it does just nudge you around.
Mm-hmm. And the 15-minute meeting they had to go, yeah, okay, sounds great.
Yeah, let boss progression continues between attempts.
Sounds good.